Well, hello and howdy, football fans, letting you know it's time for a special edition of Old Fat Frankie's Fearless Friday Forecast, brought to you by Lee's Famous Recipe here in Camelsville, Central Kentucky Video, and Two Guys, Inc. I'm Paul McQuarrie, coming to you from Take Car Studios with my good friend and good buddy, Scott Fat Frankie Franklin, and he's the world's greatest football prognosticator. We got two great football games we're going to talk about today, Coach. So let's go ahead and get started.
Coach, here it is Thanksgiving week, and it's still football time in Taylor County. Can I get two claps and a Ric Flair?
Woo! All right, Coach, we've got a big week here in Camelsville, Taylor County. We've got both school systems. We've got the Camelsville Independent School System, Taylor County School System, both winning their respective class regional championships, and just got a lot of football momentum, community pride going on right now. What do you think about that, Coach?
Well, I don't know what to think. Here we are. It's something special to practice on Thanksgiving, you know. Mm-hmm. And so tomorrow, both schools are going to have practice, I assume, tomorrow morning.
Don't
I would think
yeah,
so.
Yeah.
And that just doesn't happen. I mean, are we championship city? I know we can't say title town because, You know, there's some pretty good football over in that Bull County.
Yeah.
But, I mean, it's unreal that we have come to this here in this year where both teams were fortunate enough to win their regional championship game. Camelsville defeats Crittenden County. Taylor County with a spectacular come-from-behind victory over Louisville Moore. State semifinal games in the same year.
State implications here.
Yeah, I mean,
it's historic.
Yeah, well, speaking of history, Coach, I've done a little research, and since we're in the football mode, right?
Okay. Yeah.
I thought, you know, how did we get here? You know, for both of these teams, and there's been a lot of people who's played football in both schools.
Absolutely.
Good coaches, good players, great years, bad years, big wins, bad losses. It's just part of the ups and downs of high school football. But I thought, you know, some of the old timers, so they might enjoy some of these names I may throw out. And if I get something wrong, I firmly apologize, you know. But, you know, I've talked to a lot of people today and this week, and some of the things I know by memory and others I had to get verified.
Do a little research.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, Coach. Let's talk about Camelsville.
Camelsville?
Yeah, let's talk about Camelsville.
But, you know,
how do we get here?
Well, here's what I know. My dad used to tell me this, that Dwayne Squires was the best quarterback you ever saw. Now, I don't know if that's accurate. I wasn't around for Dwayne Squires to play, but my understanding is he's a pretty good player.
Right.
Then, you know, you get up in the 70s. I was usually a kid in the 70s.
Do I remember?
Was you a kid in the 70s?
Absolutely.
Me too. So I used to sneak in over at the games at Camelsville High School.
How did you get in?
Well,
there was a little hole
over in the fence, and I'd slide through to go watch
Coach
the Eagles
Davis,
play.
You might want to check on that.
Well, I think they got patched up pretty good over. But I remember in the 70s, they had guys like Terry Curry. He was like 6'4", 6'5", like 285.
Yeah.
He went to UK.
Oh.
You know, they had the guy Craig Beard.
Yeah.
You ever heard of him?
Yeah,
I
heard
of
Craig Beard.
Right?
Yeah, he's a physician in Bowling Green. Yeah.
You know, he went to play football at Eastern, I think. And Terry Taylor, you know, Big Terry?
I do. Terry
in my opinion, the best quarterback that I've seen personally. But, you know, that's always debatable. But you know, they got beat by Fort Campbell twice.
Yeah.
Harrodsburg. By the way, those teams all won the state championship.
Yeah.
But really good football teams back in the old days.
Yeah.
And then you get up in the 80s, and it's kind of bounced around. You know, I think in 84 they won the district at Camelsville, got beat by Russellville.
Right, yeah.
Russellville won the state championship.
Right.
Team. And then you go on up there, you got great teams at Perry Thomas, you know, and a lot of different players like, you know, golly, Joel Thompson, Timmy Mays, Chad Diener, Petey Spaulding. You remember him?
I
remember going to some games over there to watch. They hosted Harrodsburg and Mayfield. Mm-hmm. I think those were semi-state games.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, they weren't able to pull those off. But all these things and so many, many, many other players and teams that were great. You know, back in the old days, Harry Reif was the coach over there.
That's right.
Chuck Smith was over for a little while.
Yeah.
Remember
heard
of him?
Yeah, he's the Bull County fame.
And all that leads up to the last couple of years of Camelsville with Coach Estes and, you know, a back-to-back region champ.
Absolutely. He's done a great job.
Yeah. Tremendous time, and we wasn't nothing but the best.
Absolutely. Always hospitable.
Yeah.
I tell you what, while we're talking about Camelsville, let's take a little trip out to Camelsville. I think they're practicing today, so stick around, and we'll be right there in just a second. Hey, everybody. Paul McQuarrie, Scott Franklin, Malachi Corley, Campbellsville Eagles. We're here on a beautiful day before Thanksgiving, and we're preparing a little episode for the regional champions here, Class A regional champions. And they head to Beachwood Friday night to what's their nickname, Coach? What are the Beachwoods? What's their nickname?
I don't know. They're just known as state champions.
It don't matter. But we're here with the Eagles, and again, we got Malachi Corley and Coach. I'm going to turn the microphone over to you and let you ask a few questions.
Malachi, back-to-back region champs. What's that feel like for you personally? And tell us a little bit about how it's been at school this week. I know it's a short week, and y'all only had 2 days of school, but what's it been like at school this week?
It's been a great accomplishment so far, and at school, everyone's been excited. Everyone's been ready for the next big thing.
Now, Malachi, I know it's Beachwood, tradition-rich school, but you guys saw them last year. You know what you're up against. Tell us a little bit about what you think you guys need to do this Friday night to pull off an upset. We are an underdog here. Both teams are going to be an underdog in their games, but the underdogs win. What can you guys do to offset Beachwood and have an opportunity to advance the state championship game?
Well, Beachwood is a very fundamentally sound team, and in order to beat them, we're going to have to play just as fundamentally sound and have to come out and use our speed and quickness and our ability to pass the ball to get ahead of them.
Awesome. Malachi, I want to congratulate you on such a great season. I think you're rated in the top probably 10 in rushing and top 10 in receiving and Class A football. And scoring also, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. It's great individual accomplishments, but football's a team game, and we wish you nothing but the best of luck Friday night against the Beachwood Tigers up in Northern Kentucky, man.
Thank you, sir.
Hey, everybody, again, we're switching gears here. We've gone from the speed guy that gets a lot of show over to the guy that runs things. This is the captain of the field, quarterback Aaron Hash. Aaron, congratulations on your regional championship, and we're glad that you would speak to Fat Frankie's Fearless Friday Forecast crew. I'm going to turn the mic over to Frank. He's going to ask you a couple of questions.
Aaron, once again, congratulations on back-to-back region champs. That's the first time in school history. I know it's been a great year for you personally. I know it's a team game. I talked to Malachi, but what a great year you've had. I looked at the stats, and you and the Beachwood quarterback are both ranked really, really high as far as passing yards, touchdowns, low interceptions. Tell us about last Friday night. The game was a little closer than I thought it was going to be. I talked to Coach Estes, said we made a few mistakes. But tell us about last Friday night and what it meant to win the regional championship for the second year in a row.
It was just awesome, man. It was just great for the community, just giving them hope and just, like, awesome seeing those little kids just look up to us, just everything like that, Lord.
Tell us about you don't have to give us any key ingredients to the game plan this Friday night, but tell us what you're going to be looking at, what you're up against this Friday night, and what you need to improve. You played this team last year. They're always good. It's no secret. They're a very good team. But when you get this far, everybody's a good team, including you guys. So tell us what you're going to be focusing on Friday night against the Beachwood Tigers.
Just got to be accurate and disciplined, just like making no mistakes, basically.
Okay. Aaron, back-to-back region champs. First time in school history. I know Coach Estes is proud of you guys, and the community is too, and we wish you nothing but the best Friday night and your long journey up to Northern Kentucky. Underdogs win. We see it every week, and hopefully that's what's going to happen this week. Good luck.
Thank you,
buddy.
Thank you.
Hey, guys. We are here with Class A region champion Dale Estes, Campbellsville Eagles, right here in Campbellsville, Kentucky. Second year in a row that we have accomplished this feat, and very proud of Dale and what he's done here at the school. The Campbellsville Eagles travel up to the Tigers of Beachwood Friday night and for a big semi-state showdown. Frank, what you got, buddy?
Well, first of all, Coach Dale, congratulations on back-to-back region champs. Never done before here at Campbellsville High School. Let me give you a little side note. Really, really proud of Dale. I don't know if a lot of people know Dale lived up the street from him when he was a little kid. Threw ball with him, think a lot of him. He got a great opportunity and, you know, two streets over going to the region champs two times in a row, heading to the semi-state. Real proud of Dale.
Thank you.
And Dale, uphill battle this week. We know we got Beachwood. That's no secret. Tell us about the Tigers, what we're looking up against when all the fans go up to Beachwood to see what's going to happen.
They're a very good football team. They, the easiest way I could put it to you is, you know, when you watch film, you like to find something that they're not very good at. and I can't find nothing on them, you know. For 2 years in a row now, you know, they do what they do on offense. They do it well. They do what they do on defense. They do it well. And special teams are well. They're very disciplined in every aspect of the game. I mean, if their key is supposed to be this, their kids do it. You know, and that's one of the things, you know, that's one of the first things I try to look at, especially offensively, since, you know, I'm the offensive coordinator, call plays and stuff. I try to see what on their defense can we try to take advantage of for us. But, you know, they're not very weak at many things. They're pretty good. They're a very good program. They're very well coached. And, you know, they got good athletes. And, you know, they got good players. And so we know we got an uphill battle. But, you know, I told the kids this week, you know, we're going up there and we're not trying to fool ourselves and say that, you know, we can, we're a better program than them right now. We're trying to get there, you know. But, you know, my message to the team was very simple. You know, all you got to do is be better than them one night. One night. You know, it happens every year in the NCAA basketball tournament. It happens every Saturday and Sunday when we watch football games on TV. Somebody beats somebody ain't supposed to be. So that's what we're doing. We're going up there and we're going to say, for one night, we're going to be better than them. And we're going to give it everything we got. And hopefully, you know, we come out victorious.
Coach, I believe there's nothing better than getting to practice on Thanksgiving in high school. There's a lot of great accomplishments. Obviously, going to state championship game, everybody's dream. But as far as practicing on Thanksgiving Day is just a wonderful event for any high school player. They'll remember it the rest of their life. Hopefully we advance and remember more. But tell us what your schedule is for Thursday and Friday and in regards to getting to Beechwood and tomorrow on Thanksgiving Day.
I agree with you. You know, last year we got to experience practicing on Thanksgiving, and I've got some buddies in the state that I still talk to, some mentors like Chuck Smith and those guys, you know, that I still talk to. And you know, they've won a lot of state championships, but they've always told me, said, but there ain't nothing like on that Thursday morning. Waking up practicing on Thanksgiving, and we got to do it last year. And tomorrow we're going to do it again, and I can't wait. But we'll come in 9 o'clock in the morning, and we'll practice to 9:45. And then our staff at Camelsville High School, they did it last year. They will feed the kids like a Thanksgiving breakfast with a bunch of casseroles and some biscuits and some things of that nature. So we'll go in there and do that, and I'll have a little devotion for them. And then we'll send them out on their way, and they'll be done Thursday to be able to enjoy time with their families and all that stuff and things of that nature, you know, enjoy some time and knowing they can watch a little football, knowing that, you know, we still get to put the gear on one more time and play at Friday night. And then we'll come in on Friday at 12. We'll have a team meal, and we'll eat at Colton's at 12 o'clock tomorrow, and we'll feed them real good. And then as soon as we get done eating at Colton's, we'll head over here and get ready, and we'll have a bus here, and we're trying to pull out somewhere between 1:45 and 2 o'clock to head to Beechwood.
Dale, what time is the game time Friday night for all those folks watching that might want to make the journey up to see the Eagles take on the Tigers to go to the state championship game?
7:30. 7:30, they're on the same time we are, so 7:30 start. And, you know, their coach up there told me they will be a packed house. And tickets
sure
are
will
on,
be, absolutely.
The tickets are only $5 for adults, $3 for students.
Great price.
You know, so it's a great price. And he says, you know, they charge that no matter what. And, you know, and he, you know, they came down here last year. They brought a lot of people, and he told me, he just said, you know, he said, we're looking, we'll treat you right, and they will. They'll be very respectful and stuff. And, you know, so 7:30, and we're going to get up there a few hours early like we always do. But I want the kids to be able to look around a little bit because I've heard that place is just absolutely beautiful.
I've never been there, but that's what they tell me.
Me neither. And, you know, I want the kids to soak it in a little bit. I don't want them to be in awe of it, but I want them to understand, you know, we want to start doing, making this a tradition every year, and, you know, we want to show them what the great programs in the state, Class A, what they're like, and we're looking forward to going up there and playing, and hopefully, not hopefully, I know we will, our kids will be ready to play, but hopefully we'll come out on top.
Absolutely. Dale, once again, congratulations on such a great season Thank this y'all. Year, and nothing but the best of luck Friday night, and I hope you bring it back home to Camelsville.
I'd like to wish Taylor County good luck as well.
Thank you, Dale.
Like
we're going to go talk to them a little bit.
I appreciate it.
All right, guys, thank you. All right, Coach. It's good to visit with Dale over on his home
turf.
All right, now, so we've talked a little bit about Camelsville and what they've got coming up. Let's talk about our own Taylor County Cardinals here. Coach, kind of run through a little history of what you know about the Cardinal football program.
Yeah. I mean, it is a great week to talk about football.
Absolutely.
By the way, Kentucky plays Louisville on this Saturday, too.
Oh, well, yeah.
Nice colors.
I like it.
You know, Taylor County, Doug Wolford, I think Doug Wolford, first quarterback in Taylor County history.
Yeah,
I think he took a
and
lot.
And Doug
of,
works still yeah. works for us here.
I think he took a lot of hits too. Mm-hmm. A few times I've talked to him, but probably you know I can remember in the '70s a great running back Tommy Pro. Mm-hmm. Everybody tells me how good he was. Yeah. And then you know some of the old timers tell me that some of the guys in the early '80s like Jason Baxter, Milt Williams, Ron Turner, good running back, and if I'm recalling right, a guy named Alan Smith, tremendous receiver. you know. But up at that point, to my knowledge, there was no playoff action.
Yeah,
they didn't. Yeah, played some tough teams, really good teams, good players.
Right.
And the first time Taylor County made a playoff and got an opportunity to play in the playoffs was 1984. Doug Wingler.
Oh, yeah.
Starting quarterback.
College coach out in California.
In my opinion, maybe the best quarterback I've seen at Taylor County, but I didn't see some of them guys early. And they lost to Meade County. Back then, you had sub-districts. I don't know what the heck that means anymore.
Yeah.
So, anyway, they won theirs and had to play Meade County, I believe, and some guy named Elliot Ditto. He's still running. I mean, he
200
was
200-some yards that game.
It was crazy. He's really good. And then, you know, you get up into the 80s and so forth. It's a little different. And it's a little bit different, you know, playoff changes, you know, top four. But the actual first time that after that, I believe.
Let me interrupt you. You know what I remember? Of course, I played for Adair County back in the day. And we weren't very good. But I remember you talking about those 80 teams. I remember the 80, probably the 81, 82 team at Taylor County, that Doug Wingler, Kerry Cox, and those guys were part
83,
of.
Somewhere there, yeah.
Yeah, I just remember I was a young kid playing defensive end, and they hit me so hard.
Bless your heart.
I could look through my ear hole on my helmet. So, anyway, good teams.
Well, I think the first time I played Taylor County, they flipped the tight end, and I eagled down, and Jeff Parsons was across from me. I was a little nervous.
Big Jeff.
I think I weighed about 158 pounds. I don't recall.
Good time.
But anyway, then you get to the first real playoff game was in 98. Guess who we played here at Taylor County?
Who?
At Franklin Simpson.
Oh, the upcoming opponent. Jack Neely.
The fighting Jack
Neely. Before we even knew Jack Neely.
We didn't even know that here. They beat us 40-34.
Ooh.
Oh, it was a dandy game.
It was a defensive struggle, huh?
Yeah. They were good. They were really good. Yeah. We had a chance to score late and just didn't quite get done.
Okay.
And then, you know, 99, Taylor County's best season in football history. And
right.
Up to this
history.
Point, you know.
That's right.
Guys like Brandon Gupton, Ryan Atwood.
Jamie Noe.
Ryan Cox. Derek Skaggs.
Really
good
team.
You know, by the way, Camelsville's 99 team, in my opinion, that may have been their best team in the modern day, got upset by Somerset after beating them like 42-14 or something like that 2 or 3 weeks earlier. Or that could have been the year that both teams advanced.
Yeah.
But it didn't happen that way. It just shows how rare this opportunity is here this year with both schools.
So, I tell you what. Let's go talk to Jason Foley and a couple of Jason's players at Taylor County High School's football practice. Well, hey, folks, we are here at Taylor County High School football field, and we are interviewing some of the players for Taylor County High School. And today, we've got one of the players we're going to interview is Trey Gooden. Trey is a running back slash wide receiver slash wildcat quarterback. He's slash whatever you want him to make him for Taylor County football. And we are celebrating the 4A regional championship, and we've got a big game coming up. And Trey, congratulations, number one. I want to congratulate you on a great season so far. But Coach Franklin's got some questions for you.
Trey, also, I want to congratulate you as well as the rest of Taylor County Cardinals. Second region championship in the history of school, first time since 1999. Big win last night here on a sloppy field against Louisville Moore. Tell me your thoughts about how that game went last Friday. I know that we had a big comeback at the end. Just give me what was going through your mind during that time towards the end of that game.
Well, you see, we started off kind of slow, I thought, but, you know, after halftime, we got in the locker room, made adjustments, and we came out strong, you know, had to keep our heads up even though we were down, but we just made sure we bonded together as a team and came through adversity.
All right, so this week we've got the Fighting Jack Neelys, as I like to call them, the Franklin Simpson Wildcats. I believe Franklin Simpson's lost one game this year to South Warren. So I look at the stats, they're averaging about 42 points. We're averaging about 40 points. So, you know, a running team from what I gather, running the old wing tee. What have you seen on film? You don't have to give away all the secrets, but tell me the keys to stopping Franklin Simpson and this vaunted running attack that we're going up against.
Well, mainly against Franklin Simpson, I think that their two main threats will be their fullback and number 10 is Trey Bass, their main running back. So as long as we can contain those two and make sure they don't get, you know, any yards and make sure they don't score, I think we can hold them.
All right, Trey, Coach McQuarrie said something about slash on it. Google slash played for the Pittsburgh Steelers a long time ago. You might Google that. He's a pretty good player. On a personal note, I know that you're one of the leading scorers in the state in 4A as far as averages. And Mr. McQuarrie, he elaborated a little bit about all the things you do, including kick returns. Of all the things you do, DB,
kick return, offense, defensive strategies that you have, plays that you're in. What's your favorite today?
Ooh, that's a tough question.
DB, but, kickoff return, punt return, offensive running back, wide receiver.
Honestly, I'm going to have to say DB because, you know, there's just something about playing defense, coming down, making hits. You know, it's just like there's no feeling like when you come down and make a big hit. Just, the crowd goes wild, your team gets hype, you know, just gets everybody ready, you know, just keep going.
Awesome. Trey, best of luck Friday night here at Cardinal Field against Franklin Simpson.
Hey, folks, we are here with Taylor County High School starting quarterback and kind of know this guy a little bit, Grant McQuarrie, number 7. Grant, congratulations on your regional championship. I know you played had an emotional ride there at the very last series, last 5 or 6 plays, but you kind of came through that and stepped up to the plate big. Congratulations on your 4A regional championship. And I'm going to let Coach Franklin talk to you just a little bit. He's got a few questions for you.
Grant, obviously, my first question is, what were you thinking with 23 seconds left? And I don't know what the play call is. I know nothing about all that. Tell me what's going through your mind. Is it slow motion? Are you slowing down? Are you speeding up? Tell me what your thought process was on that play with roughly 20-some seconds left that sealed the deal for Taylor County.
My thought process during that was exactly what Coach Foley told me to do, and that was to read the safety. Of course, we put Trey Gooden in motion, and if he went with Trey, then I'm throwing it to Irv. If he stuck with Dejon, then I was throwing it to Trey. And I was pretty confident in the play call, and I just had to trust my instincts.
Sounded like you made the right decision then. I assumed then that the safety went with the motion guy and you threw the opposite direction. Tell me about school this week. I know you're only in school Monday and Tuesday. What was it like at Taylor County High School? It's only the second time in school history that the Cardinals have won a region in football. Tell me about how things were at school this week.
School, you know, I mean, it's pretty normal. But, yeah, the talk was about the football game. And, you know, I feel like it'll be the talk for a few more days up until this Friday. And hopefully they'll keep talking about next Friday for the next one.
Well, I know I briefly said something to Trey about how we're going to attack their offensive schemes or a big run team. Let's go on the other side. Obviously, I'm sure you've watched a lot of film on Franklin Simpson with the Huddle app. Everybody's got the Coach Esther said they got 8 or 9 films on Beachwood. I'm sure you've looked at no matter how many films of Franklin Simpson. What are you going to be facing? What do they look like on defense, and what's the key for it? You don't have to give away any secrets, but what are you looking at against the Franklin Simpson defense?
I would love to establish our run first, but they would also need to prepare for our spread offense. I feel like we established that pretty well last Friday. I feel like you know, we can do anything, and they have a lot to prepare for, and you know, I like to go into that game and do a little bit of everything.
Okay, great. Grant, congratulations on the second region championship in the history of the school, and a big play last week that a lot of people remember for a long time.
Yes, sir.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Well, hey guys, we are here with 4A region champion coach Jason Foley. Jason, in only your second year, you've taken the Cardinals to their first regional championship since 1999. That is how many years? 19, 18 years, something like that. That's a lot of years. And coach, we're so tickled with our program here and what you've done with the program. And so I'm going to turn the mic over to Mr. Franklin here, and Coach Franklin, old Fat Frankie, is going to ask you a few questions.
Coach, first of all, congratulations on the big win last Friday night against Louisville Moore, second region championship in the history of school, and only your second year at school at this school, as Coach McQuarrie elaborated on. Tell us a little bit about what your thoughts were going into that game last week, and then what in the heck did you think at the end of that game?
Well, I appreciate that. I appreciate you congratulating us and everything. It's been a great ride for us. It's been a great year, and I'm very proud of our team and the way they've came on throughout the season. As far as Louisville Moore goes, we knew they were a very good football team. Both of us had 11-1 record. I think we both had a district championship. Both of us had won several games in a row. We had a lot of respect for them, but we just knew we had to come out and play a good football game, and I think we came on in that second half and made it happen. late in the game, you're right, things was looking a little bleak a couple of times, but our kids just never gave up. They kept fighting, and got the opportunity there at the end to make some plays. And I always say, big-time players make big-time plays, and that's what they did.
Coach, I've, you know, just kind of glancing through the statistics, Franklin Simpson's got a good rushing attack, a couple guys that's rushed for 1,500 yards. They don't throw it much. You know, I'm looking at Taylor County. I know Grant's rated in the top probably 10 or 12 passers in 4A. Wes Oliver's one of the top running backs as far as yards and so forth. Trey's in there and scoring. And our defense, is, as far as Taylor County is concerned, is rated first or second, whatever points given up. And Franklin Simpson is very similar in most of those areas except for the passing. Tell us a little bit about Franklin Simpson, what we're going to see. You know, obviously you don't want to give anything away, but what can our fans look for when the Wildcats roll in here Friday night?
Well, they've got a great rushing attack. You know, they love to run the football. You know, I think their percentage is somewhere around 90-10 or 95-5 with a run-pass ratio. And they've been to the state finals 2 years in a row. They've won the state championship last year, and so they're riding high, got a lot of support, and we know the type of team they are and what they bring to the table. But, you know, we feel like if we have a good week of prep the rest of the way, we've had two good days already, and, you know, we feel like that we can go in with a good game plan and have a good shot as long as we come out and play a good game. But we definitely have a lot of respect for them and what they bring, and we just got to be ready to play.
Coach, as a high school player, it's my opinion that there's nothing better than getting to practice on Thanksgiving morning. Now, I don't know what your schedule is. Share with our guys that watch this. What's the Cardinal schedule tomorrow? And then Friday, you know, it's no school. Tell us a little bit about what your preparation is going to be, and in particular tomorrow.
Yeah, well, this week so far, everything's been pretty normal. But now things change a little bit with Thanksgiving. And we're going to actually have a practice tomorrow morning, bring our guys in at 9 o'clock for a team meeting. And we'll probably hit the field about 9:30, and we've actually invited former alum, families, former players, you know, anybody that's a Taylor County football fan to come out and watch us practice tomorrow. But we'll go on the field about 9:30, and we'll do our pregame till about 11:10, and just kind of running through everything that we do. And so then we'll let our kids go for the rest of the day to, you know, have some Thanksgiving with their families and things like that. And then on Friday, we'll come in and do a little walkthrough at 11 a.m. and just kind of get our guys up and moving, you know, have a little chalk talk, and then just get ready to play after that.
Well, Coach, you know, we've got two teams in our own community playing to go to the state championship, which is unheard of in our local community. Danville and Boyle County is the closest one that I know of over in Titletown. But congratulations on a great season, and we hope it continues, and we wish you nothing but the best of luck against the Wildcats of Franklin Simpson.
Thank you, Mr. Franklin, Mr. McQuarrie, and appreciate everyone's support. And we invite everyone out tomorrow at 7:30. It'll be a big game and a big big chance for us to get the W, hopefully. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, Coach. So we've met with both coaches. We've met with some players for both Campbellsville and Taylor County. And so now it's time to talk about the old Smart Pill Machine, Coach. What does the Smart Pill Machine – what does it look like, the old crystal ball? What are you thinking?
Well, Coach, you know, at this point in time, everybody you play is really good. That means you're really good and who you're playing is really good. You know, the Mighty Eagles have to travel all the way up north to go to Beechwood. The Tigers, I mean, it's just like a football factory. I think Beechwood's 10-2. You know, they've lost two games.
Right.
The two games they've lost to, I think, are the Covenant Catholic and Corbin.
Two respectable opponents.
Yes, who are still playing this weekend also. I'm not going to pick a winner because at this point in time, we're all winners. Yeah. And this, I mean, good day where we're playing with the Final Four.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know? So
absolutely.
What does Campbellsville have to do to win? First of all, they're an underdog, just like Taylor County is going to be an underdog against Franklin Simpson. Everything's going to have to go right. They have some experience. They played them last year. So they know what they're up against, and they know what it's going to take to be successful at this level. Can they do it? I don't know. But right. Underdogs win every week, you know, on Fridays and Saturdays and Sundays. We see it all the time. It just, you know, I think Coach Estes said something about to when we're talking, you just got to beat them one time. You ain't got to beat them 10 times.
You just got to be better than them one time.
That one night. So we're hoping that the Eagles on this one night are a little bit better than
absolutely.
The Tigers.
Absolutely. All right, so let's talk about the Taylor County Cardinals, Coach. What do you think
Taylor
about
Taylor County, we got the fighting Jack Neely's of Franklin Simpson. The Wildcats are rolling in. They run, I believe they run that wing T. Mm-hmm. If I'm not mistaken, they got two guys, not one guy, two guys that have exceeded like 1,500 yards.
Right.
They don't throw it. I think they've only thrown it like 61 times all year long. So, you know,
so
it's a ground and pound, wing tee, misdirection type deal. Once again, the Cardinals, I think, in most people's eyes, are an underdog also. But they're playing at home. Probably going to be a sloppy track would be my guess based on field conditions from last week. you know, once again, it's a one-time deal. We don't have to beat Franklin Simpson 10 times. We just got to beat them once, and hopefully that's Friday night. Chances are it could happen. Yep. It could happen at both schools. And as a community, I sure hope it does.
Absolutely.
And
it'd
be wonderful
for
our community, both schools to go. It'd be unbelievable.
Yes,
this right here is just unbelievable as it is right now.
That's
another win would just be icing on the cake.
All right. Well, that's all we have for this week, folks. Old Fat Frankie himself will be back next season with more football predictions. Giving a big shout out to the guy that always makes this thing happen, sitting right there behind the camera, old Diamond Dave Tennell. If you have any aerial photography needs, make sure you give Dave a call at the number that will be popping up on the screen shortly. This is Paul McQuarrie, hoping that you'll tune in next season. And until then, go Cards.
Go Eagles.